Alright, what's up, YouTube? I'm trying to make sure you guys see my face. I apologize. This is an old cell phone, so I don't know if you guys can actually see me, but this is my second video. This is my back-to-back video. As you can see, I am at the Grove Park, trying to give you guys a nice insight of where I'm at. See, we're not in the backyard. We're at the Grove, so I'm trying to give you guys a nice general idea of where I do my filmmaking. Now, this video is not going to be a filmmaking thank you video. This one's going to be a video that I've never thought I would make into a video. And this video is going to be for the sexy white women and the sexy Latina women that are police officers. Now, the reason why this is getting made is because it's a new video, okay? It's a new content video. This idea was very well planned, very well thought out. Thoughts were planted out. Now, the title of the video is going to be called Sex Game. I like sexy, hot, white / Latina women that are police officers. Now, before somebody reacts to the title of the video and thumbs down the video and go, women police officers, well, first let me explain. Before anybody judge a book by its cover and get in their feelings, let me try to explain logically. See, a lot of white women are police officers. A lot of Latino women are police officers. We will always, and I mean always, 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, will give white men, black men, and Latino men that are police officers the respect and the credit that they deserve. But we have some white women and we have some Latino women in recent years that are also decorated police officers. Now, before somebody gets the wrong idea in this video and say, oh, you're just kissing somebody's butt. Well, first of all, there's kissing somebody's butt, which I don't condone, and you know what I mean. And then there's, I get checked out. Like, apparently, there was this one white woman that I find very physically sexually attractive. It actually happened today, like about 2 hours ago. I was in Beverly Hills. I was trying to find this building for a job interview, but probably not going to find it because once it gets to 2 o'clock, they stop doing interviews. And then I have to wait until next week or 2 or 3 weeks later when they do another section of job interviews. Yes, they are doing job interviews as we speak. And I was being checked out by a white woman in a truck that was a police officer for the Beverly Hills Police Department. And I've noticed in the beginning of 2020, I've been getting looks from women that are police officers. And sometimes I don't know where it comes from. I guess they find me very physically sexually attractive. Some women find me physically sexually attractive. Some think I'm just okay and average. And then you have that small minority group that go, you're not attractive at all. And I'm okay with every outcome. I'm okay with some people thinking I'm very physically sexually attractive. I'm okay with some people saying I'm average. And I'm even okay with some people that don't think I'm nothing. Because I've always had to prove naysayers, the skeptics, the player haters, and the critics. I've always had to prove them wrong no matter what I did in life. So I'm used to that type of criticism. But I've noticed that this is like the third or fourth time this has happened. You know, it's a white girl in a police car. She got a sexy, hot smile. She's checking me out. I'm smiling. She thinks I'm cute. I think she's cute. And the question has to be answered. Do I find sexy white women and sexy Latina women, mamacitas, that are police officers very physically sexually attractive? And the answer is yes, yes, yes. Now, before somebody say why you keep saying yes, it's because I get hit on by a lot of white women that are police officers. I've noticed it in Santa Monica, Beverly Hills. Sometimes I be thinking I'm gonna get stopped and, you know, approached. You know, sometimes you go into an area that you're not supposed to go into, and sometimes people be like, what you doing in the area? And sometimes I say hi, because if you show a police officer the correct amount of respect, they show respect back in return. Now, I know somebody's going to watch this video and take this video the wrong way 90% of the time and go, there's police brutality. And I forgot about police brutality. I'm going to make a completely separated video once I get all the information on that and try to sit down and turn that into a three-part series. Because one video ain't going to be enough. Two videos ain't going to be enough. I'm going to have to make at least three videos. And I might have to get some permission because I have to interview some people on that subject. Because a friend of mine did that and he got a very bad critical reception on his YouTube channel when he makes those types of videos. And I don't want to put the wrong information into a video and it ain't the right information. Because people watch these videos, they're not stupid. And when you insult any man or any woman's intelligence, that's rude and disrespectful. So, you know, give me about until the end of the year, and then I'll let you know if I can make the video or not, because I made some videos in the past that pertain to another subject, and some of those videos, they were not critical received. It's like doing a movie or a television show. Some people, if you make a video and they don't understand it, then you can't make that video, because I made some videos in the beginning of my career, and they were not that very well received. Because it goes back to the rule. If you insult any man or any woman's intelligence, that's rude and disrespectful. Doesn't matter if they're young or old, black or white. You insult someone's intelligence, they're going to have an issue and a problem with that. Now, the reason why I like white women that are police officers is because they stay in great, fantastic, athletic shape. Okay? It don't matter what their age is. Their 20s, their 30s, their 40s, their 50s. They stay in great athletic shape, they eat their fruits and vegetables, they drink a lot of water, and they take their job very serious. And a lot of times, if you need some help, if you're in the area, you'll get some help. And the reason why I'm making the video is because I had no idea, and I mean this, I had no idea at all that sexy white women that are police officers found me physically sexually attractive. I mean, of course, I find them physically sexually attractive because they're in athletic shape. And like I told you before, it don't matter if she's BBW, don't matter if she's tall, short, young or old. I do like white women that are police officers, very physically sexually attractive. They're very nice. You know, you show some respect. They show some respect back in return. On the other hand, we have the sexy Latina, the sexy mamacita. As of lately, they also have been looking in my direction. Now, you might say, well, it's because you do all these YouTube videos and these videos go viral. Yes, they do watch my YouTube videos. And is that a surprise and a shock? For me, it is, because I'm used to people that I went to high school and college and at work watching my YouTube videos. But when you get somebody that's empowered to protect you watching your videos, that's like a completely different experience. You know, they have that sexy smile, and I'm talking about the sexy mamacita that's a police officer. They're very, very physically, sexually attractive, and what I like about them is they're very assertive. They know when it's time to say something, and they know when it's not time to say something. They know when it's time to intervene, and they know when it's time to not intervene. They're very good. They got very good people skills. Now, some people might say, I don't know what you're basing the experiences off of. Well, let me use today's experience for a prime example. I mean, you just don't expect this white girl was fine as hell. Like, she smiled at me when she saw me. And I kind of said, you know what, let me go ahead and make a video and talk about my experiences. Now, before I continue in the video, let me just say this, because there are some men who also watch my video. I'm not saying that I'm giving everyone a opportunity to say that they're perfect. Nobody's perfect. Everybody makes mistakes. Everybody's human. Okay? Now, my experiences are good. That doesn't mean your experience is going to be good, okay? It's like if I play basketball, and I've been playing basketball for 14 years, I'm really good at playing basketball. But no stretch and no means of an imagination, I am Michael Jordan. I will never be Michael Jordan. I will never be Kobe Bryant. I will never be LeBron James, okay? But that also goes for this experience. just because I have a good experience with white women and Latino women that are police officers, that doesn't mean my best friend who does YouTube videos has a good experience. Because his experience is the complete opposite. He works and lives in a very high class area, and if you're not home by a certain time, they will approach you and ask you what you're doing after hours. Now, when I'm in the area and I see the police, I get a different experience. Some people might say, you're being treated like our Hollywood celebrities. Now, I'm not a celebrity, and I never said I get treated like a celebrity, but that experience feels like it. See, being a celebrity and feel like a celebrity are two different experiences. And that's going to be a future YouTube video, because some people think that when we do YouTube videos, we do it for that one purpose, to be a YouTube superstar and try to be celebrity. But I'm trying to explain a compare and contrast in this video. And I'm trying to carefully explain to the best of my ability, because even though people understand my videos, there are times where I make some good videos that, even though they're very well received, sometimes in the first 10, 15, 20 minutes, people don't understand what it is that I'm trying to say in the video. Whether I'm talking too slow, whether I'm talking too loud. I try not to talk too loud because I got some feedback from some people, and they tell me when you talk too loud, you come off angry and intimidating. So I'm trying to find better ways to speak in videos without sounding too loud or intimidating. And if I sound too low or too soft, then people are going to say you're not speaking enough and they can't hear you. So I'm trying to find a balance within these videos so everyone can understand me, men and women, young and old, black or white. I'm not trying to offend anyone here. Today's a very good Friday. It's a good day. And what better way to make a video? Now, would I ever ask out a sexy white woman that's a police officer out to lunch and dinner? Maybe one day. I don't know. I mean, I'd have to get a house, a car, and a job. Would I ever ask a sexy Latina, a sexy mamacita that's a police officer out to lunch and dinner? Yes. Because when I see a white woman, I see a beautiful, attractive white woman. I don't see, oh, she's a police officer. I see a human being who's doing her job. When I see a sexy Latino woman, I don't see a police officer. I see a Latino woman who's doing her job to the best of her ability. Now, before someone come in the comment section and say, what about black women? We're going to add in black women in another video, because I got to do some research on that, because a friend of mine made a video recently and people got mad at the video because he did not do proper research. And from what I understand is, when you do videos and you just put them on the internet just because, people get upset because you insult their intelligence. And the last thing you want is to insult someone's intelligence. So the reason why I said white women and Latino women is because about 60 to like 70% of the time, that's what I see a lot. Anytime I'm on the bus, I'm on the train, I always see a sexy white woman or a Latino woman that's a police officer. Now, there are some black women that are police officers too, but I have to do the research on that and find out the year when that started to happen. Because what's going to happen is one group going to like the video and the other group of the video going to have an issue with the video. Because I look at the analytics, and the analytics tells me when I do good, when I do bad, what are my best videos, what are my worst videos, and it goes based on what I do and what I say in the video. And when I get comments, I get good comments and I get bad comments. So basically what I'm trying to say is those are my positive experiences. And this started happening when I got my first job at the Grove. You know, now you can say when I was at the Grove, all the women that are police officers were nice to me. Same thing with the men and women in our armed forces in the military. For the most part, they've been nice to me. Now, my best friend, on the other hand, not a very good interaction with the police. He has a great interaction with our armed forces, but when it comes to the police, he has a bad, you know, interaction. I have good interactions with the police. Now, with security, for the most part, it's pretty okay. It's pretty decent. It's kept to the bare minimum. I say hi to the security guards. I'm not forgetting about them either. You know, you got some women that are in security. That will be a completely separated video. So this was just to basically clarify, and the reason why I made it is because it's been happening. This whole entire year has been happening to me, and I said, you know what, let me go ahead and make a video and see what happens. Now, I don't expect everybody to like the video. I do not expect everybody to be excited or understanding of the video. If you get upset with the video, it's understandable. If you comment and say why you made this video and what was the purpose of this video, you watch the video before you judge its conclusion, good or bad. Until next time, peace.